Have you been looking for the shared matches tool on GEDMatch? Well, it's got a funny name, but it's also got more features than any of the other shared matches tools. Howdy, welcome to Family History Fanatics, where we love helping you climb your family tree and have fun along the way. Before we continue, if you want to help support our work, there's many ways you can do that. There are links in the description below to our website, to show notes, and free guides. But the most important thing is to leave a comment and share this video with others. We continue to grow thanks to people like you. Shared matches tools are very useful in starting to identify groups of people that share common ancestors. And so it's important to be able to see which matches you share with other matches. Now in GEDMatch, that shared match tool has a little bit of a different name. So let's go over to GEDMatch and see where we can find it. As I scroll down on GEDMatch, I get to the free tools section. And in that, there is a tool that is called people who match both of one or two kits. This is the tool that we want to be using in order to find our shared matches. Now, when we click on that tool, it is going to bring us to the page where we put in the parameters. Most shared matches tools, you're just going to actually click on that match and it'll show you the shared matches that you have in common with that person. But GEDMatch allows you to do some things a little bit differently. First off, there are two kit numbers. And that's where you're going to put in the kit numbers for the people that you want to see the shared matches for. Then there are some thresholds. So the first one is the centimorgan threshold that you want to use to qualify as a match. Now this default is set at 10 centimorgans. In other words, it's not going to look for any matches that don't share at least 10 centimorgans. The second threshold is the total matching segments. And this is how much total centimorgans, not just a segment, but total centimorgans a match needs to have in order for it to be considered a match on this list. Now, by default, it's set at that 10 centimorgans. It has to be at least as equal to or greater than the segment threshold. Finally, the last is this differences in generations. Now, differences in generations is between you and one of these matches and a match and this match. It might be that you are very closely related to this shared match, whereas the match you're comparing them to is very distantly related to this match. In most cases, I haven't found this very useful. There are some certain cases with endogamy where this may be important to change this. But for the vast majority of people, just leaving it at the default of 99 to start with is going to be just fine. So let me put in myself and my mother so that we can see what the shared matches tool looks like. So what we have now is we have our list of shared matches. And one of the first things that you will notice here that is different in the new version of GEDMatch is they've divided this list up into three different tabs. And that's what these are at the top. You can click on each one of those to be able to go between them. So you have the shared match list. That's this first tab right here. And that's what we're looking at in this section. Is this is the people that match both you and the other match that you put in. So it is literally a shared match list similar to what you find on Ancestry, on Family Tree DNA, on MyHeritage, and on 23andMe, as far as the matches that two people share in common. In this list, we have the identifying information as far as their kit number, what the name or the alias they're going by, and then how much they share with each one of these two people. So if we just go down a little bit here and let's take this person right here, for instance. So they share 43 centimorgans with me and the largest segment they share is 29.7 centimorgans. Now with my mom, they only share 12.8 centimorgans, and it looks like it is just one segment of that 12.8 centimorgans. So I can start to use this to see how different people may relate. Now, a lot of these you can see, I'm sharing more than my mom. And in this case, what it means is that I probably match this person really through my dad's line, And my mom and my dad have some common ancestry several generations back that some of this DNA happens to be the same. Or this person that I'm sharing with, through their mom and their dad, happen to match both sides of my family as well. So there's a couple of possibilities there. But when we look at some of these others, for instance, this one right here that shares 48 centimorgans with me and 49 centimorgans with my mom. In that case, this is probably a ancestor that is definitely through my mom's line because I share just slightly less than what she shares. There's a little bit of that DNA that's been cut off as my mom passed that DNA on to me. So this is a good starting point to see which matches might be from certain sides of your family. You can use this with first cousins or second cousins to help isolate which matches are from a certain grandparent or great-grandparent. But this is what is most commonly known as a shared match list. Now, if we go over here to the second tab, this is where it is more powerful because what these other two tabs are for is really a negative of the shared match. In other words, it's looking at a list of people that only match one of those two kits. So this first one happens to be mine. And as I scroll down here, I can see that, yeah, this list is different than what it is from the other list. And since I was using myself and my mother, in this case, most all of these matches are going to be through my father. So this is a great tool that if you have one of your parents already tested, you can use that parent and this tool to find out which matches are part of your other parent. For those who are adopted or don't know who one of their parents are, this may be very useful in getting a group of matches together and trying to figure out common ancestors from those matches. Now you noticed here that it doesn't have the information about the other match. It just has for me because they don't match the other person. And so this table is a little bit more compact than what the other one was. There's not as many columns for it. Now by the same token, this last tab here is going to be those people who match my mom, but don't match me. Now, I got half of my DNA from my mom, which means I didn't get all of my mom's DNA. So there is some DNA that my mom has that I don't have. And that's what's represented really by these matches. These people share DNA with my mom, but they don't share DNA with me because I didn't receive that DNA from my mom. They're still related to me because they're related to my mom, but I wouldn't have found them without my mom's DNA, and I wouldn't know that they are part of this. In some cases, if you're looking at a tool on GEDMatch for the evil twin, this is kind of like showing the matches for the evil twin on my mom's side. Now, the shared match tool or the people who match both kits or one of two kits can be used with any two kits. So it doesn't have to be a close relation at all. You can find somebody that you match just 20 or 30 centimorgans with and you want to see who else matches them as well and be able to do that comparison. But the goal of this tool is really to start to create groups of matches that are related through some common ancestor. With the matching both kits, you're going to look at, well, what's the common ancestor of both of those people? And that's what that matches group is part of. With the matching only one of those kits, like I showed you, we can use a parent and a child and find a group of matches that really belong to that other parent, even though we don't have that parent's DNA. So go ahead and try out the people who match both kits or one of two kits and see how you can help to group together some of your matches into people that you can start researching a common ancestor for. Now, if you have any other questions about shared matching and what you can use this tool for, put it in the comments below and I'll try to answer it for you. Now, if you want to learn more about a tool on GEDMatch, then why don't you watch this video up above? But if you're interested in something else about DNA, then try this video down below. Are Let me go back. If you like this video,